In this video, we're going to continue on to the second page of the KutaSoftware Infinite Algebra 1 worksheet, Radical Equations Part 2, otherwise known as Radical Equations Hard. Now, picking up where we left off in number 15, we're going to start by squaring both sides. So the square root of negative 45 plus 14n squared, that's going to be negative 45 plus 14n equal to n squared. So I'll subtract n squared from both sides. So I'll have negative n squared plus 14n minus 45, just switching around the order of the 45 and 14n, that's going to be equivalent to 0, since n squared minus n squared is 0. Now I don't want my n squared to be negative, so I'm going to multiply the left-hand side of my equation by negative 1, and remember, whatever I do to the left, I also need to do to the right, so that will get multiplied by negative 1. So I'll have positive n squared plus 14n times negative 1, which is a negative 14n, so subtracting 14n, and then adding 45. That's equal to 0 times negative 1, which is 0. Now I'm going to factor n squared minus 14n plus 45. So I need to see what two terms multiply to give me 45 and add to give me negative 14. The factors that will work for 45 are 5 and 9. If both 5 and 9 are negative, negative 5 plus negative 9 equals negative 14, and negative 5 times negative 9 equals a positive 45. So n squared minus 14n plus 45 factored will have n minus 5 times n minus 9, and that's equal to 0. So in order to solve for n, we're going to see when n minus 5 equals 0 and when n minus 9 equals 0. Because remember, 0 times any quantity is equal to 0. So if n minus 5 is 0, when I multiply that to n minus 9, we'll get 0. And if n minus 9 is 0, when I multiply that to n minus 5, I'll get 0. So n minus 5 is 0 when n is equal to a positive 5. 5 minus 5 equals 0. And n minus 9 equals 0 when n is equal to a positive 9. So 9 minus 9 is equal to 0. Therefore, for number 15, we have two solutions, 5 and 9, and I'll write those as a set. So this is set notation, showing that my solutions are 5 and 9. Let's continue on to number 16. In number 16, x equals the square root of 110 minus x. If you notice, this is very similar to the very first problem on this worksheet. So when we square both sides, we'll get that x squared is equal to 110 minus x. So I'm going to subtract 110 from both sides in order for my 110 to cancel out, and then I'm going to add x to both sides in order for my x to cancel out. That way I'll have 0 on my right-hand side, and on my left-hand side I'll have x squared plus x minus 110. So I need to see what two numbers multiply to give me 110, and that's a negative 110, and add to give me a positive 1. So for 110, that's going to be 10 and 11, where the 10 is negative. So we'll have x minus 10 times x plus 11, and that's equal to 0. So we need to solve for when x minus 10 equals 0 and when x plus 11 equals 0. X minus 10 equals 0 when x is equal to a positive 10. Because 10 minus 10 is 0, and x plus 11 equals 0 when x is equal to a negative 11, because negative 11 plus 11 equals 0. So those are our solutions when we factor. However, if we look back at our original equation, we have x equivalent to the square root of 110 minus x. And when we take the square root of a quantity, that's always going to be a positive number, so x cannot be negative. Therefore, x cannot be negative 11, so we have one solution in number 16, and that's 10. X equal to 10. Continuing on to number 17, we're going to start by squaring both sides. So we'll have 9n equal to n squared. And when I subtract n squared from both sides, I'll get that 9n minus n squared equals 0. And I can pull out an n term from both 9n and n squared. So I'll have n times 9 minus n equal to 0. So you can see that if I was to redistribute that n, I would indeed get 9n minus n squared. So I need to see when n is equal to 0 and when 9 minus n is equal to 0. Because when either of those are true, my equation will equal 0. So I have n equals 0, and for 9 minus n equal to 0, that's when n equals a positive 9, because 9 minus 9 equals 0. Therefore, for number 17, I have two solutions, 0 and 9. And because both of them are positive, they are true for that original. And number 18, squaring both sides, I'll get that x squared is equal to 40 minus 3x. So now I'm going to subtract 40, and I'm also going to add 3x. So I'll have x squared plus 3x minus 40 equal to 0. So now I can factor because I have this in the form of ax squared plus bx plus c. So I'm going to see what two numbers multiply to give me negative 40 and add to give me a positive 3. And the factors of 40 that will work will be 5 and 8, where that 5 is negative. Negative 5 plus 8 is a positive 3, and negative 5 times 8 is a negative 40. So I'll have x minus 5 times x plus 8 as my factored form of x squared plus 3x minus 40, and that's all equivalent to 0. So I'm going to be seeing when x minus 5 equals 0 and when x plus 8 equals 0. X minus 5 equals 0 when x is equal to a positive 5, because 5 minus 5 is 0. And x plus 8 equals 0 when x is equal to a negative 8, because negative 8 plus 8 equals 0. However, looking back at our original, we're taking the square root of a quantity, which is always going to be positive. Therefore, x cannot be negative 8, so I have one solution in number 18, and that is positive 5. X equals 5 for number 18. And number 19, when I square both sides, I get that 90 minus n equals n squared. So I'll subtract n squared from both sides. So I'll have negative n squared minus n plus 90 equal to 0. Now, I don't want my n squared to be negative, so I'm going to multiply my left-hand side by negative 1, and whatever I do to the left, I need to do to the right, so I'll also multiply 0 by negative 1. So I'll get positive n squared plus n minus 90, switching all my signs on my left-hand side. That will equal 0 times negative 1, which is 0. So now I'm going to need to factor n squared plus n minus 90. So what two numbers multiply to give me negative 90 and add to give me a positive 1. The factors of 90 that will work for this are 9 and 10. 9 times 10, where that 9 is negative. Negative 9 plus 10 is a positive 1, and negative 9 times 10 is negative 90. So I'll have n minus 9 times n plus 10. That's equal to 0. So I'm going to see when n minus 9 equals 0 and when n plus 10 equals 0. N minus 9 equals 0 when n is a positive 9. 9 minus 9 equals 0. And n plus 10 equals 0 when n is a negative 10. Negative 10 plus 10 is 0. However, looking back at that original equation, if we're taking the square root of some quantity and that's equal to n, that n has to be positive, because when we're taking the square root, we're going to get a positive answer. Therefore, n cannot be negative 10. So 9 is my solution in number 19. N equals 9. Moving on to number 20, when I square both sides, I'll get that x squared is equal to negative 70 plus 17x. So I'm going to be adding 70 to both sides, and I'm going to be subtracting 17x from both sides. So again, adding 70 and subtracting 17x. So I'll get x squared minus 17x plus 70 equal to 0. Now I'm going to factor x squared minus 17x plus 70. So the numbers that multiply to give me 70 and add to give me negative 17 are negative 10 and negative 7. X minus 10 times x minus 7 are the factors of x squared minus 17x plus 70. because negative 10 times negative 7 is positive 70, and negative 10 plus negative 7 is negative 17. So now I'm going to see when x minus 10 equals 0 and when x minus 7 equals 0. And that's true for when x is equal to 10, because 10 minus 10 equals 0, and when x is equal to 7, because 7 minus 7 equals 0. So I have two solutions in number 20, since both are positive. That's going to be 7 and 10. 7 and 10 are my solutions in number 20. Now, moving on to number 21, we're going to start by squaring both sides. However, what's different with 21 is that we're squaring our variable plus some other number on that right-hand side. So we're going to have a binomial times a binomial. So we'll have 4n plus 8 equal to, this is a plus b squared. So remember that a plus b, squaring that quantity, will get a squared plus 2ab plus b squared. So my a is n and my b is a positive 3. So n plus 3 squared will have n squared plus 2 times a times b. That's 2 times n times 3, which 2 times 3 is 6, so that's 6 times n, plus b squared, which is 3 squared, which will give us 9. If you don't feel comfortable using this formula, feel free to write out n plus 3 squared. So write it as n plus 3 times n plus 3, and then FOIL. First terms, outside terms, inside terms, last terms. N times n is n squared, n times 3 is 3n, and you'll be adding that to another 3 times n, so 3n plus 3n is 6n, and then 3 times 3 is 9. N squared plus 6n plus 9. So continuing on, I'm going to subtract 4n from both sides, and I'm going to also subtract 8 from both sides. So subtracting 4n and subtracting 8, I'll get 0 on one side of my equation. So I'll have that 0 is equal to n squared plus 6n minus 4n is 2n plus 9 minus 8 is a positive 1. So I'll be factoring n squared plus 2n plus 1, since that's equal to 0. So I need to see what two numbers multiply to give me positive 1 and add to give me a positive 2. Looking at the factors of 1, that's going to be 1 and 1. 1 times 1 is positive 1, and 1 plus 1 is positive 2. So we'll have 0 equal to n plus 1 times n plus 1, which we can simplify to have 0 equal to n plus 1 squared. And if you want to, you can always flip this equation around to have n plus 1 squared equal to 0, because 0 equals n plus 1 squared is the same as n plus 1 squared equals 0. We just switch the sides of the equation. Now, since n plus 1 squared equals 0, I need to see when n plus 1 equals 0 in order to solve. N plus 1 equals 0 when n equals negative 1, because negative 1 plus 1 equals 0. So that's my solution when I factor the equation. However, I have a negative. And previously, a negative number did not work for our original equation. However, note this was different because we were adding 3. So looking back at our original equation, we have the square root of 4n plus 8 equal to n plus 3. And if n is negative 1, when I plug negative 1 in, negative 1 plus 3 is going to equal a positive 2. So I'm going to get a positive answer, and double checking with the radical as well, plugging negative 1 in for n, I'll have the square root of 4 times negative 1 plus 8, which is negative 4 plus 8, which is the square root of a positive 4, and that does indeed equal 2. So negative 1 does work in number 21. Therefore, our solution is negative 1. And with that, I'll wrap up this video. If you have any questions, please feel free to leave them in the comments below. And if you haven't done so already, like, subscribe, and share. Continue on to the next video where I'll finish this worksheet completing numbers 22 through 28.